This message is broadcasted to raise awareness of a new drug in circulation. The Snyle drug. We advise for you to stay away from any person suspected to be under its influence. For the past few months, we have received over 500 deaths related to the drug. The drug itself has not been scientifically investigated. Its most obvious effects are mania, uncontrollable laughter, violent tendencies, and the alleged Snyle in which the drug was named after. How do you ensure your safety outside? Avoid dark alleys since most reported deaths happened near or in a dark alley. If you hear suspicious laughter, run as fast as you can. Avoid eye contact with the person. Once the person notices you, it will begin pursuit. Do not interact. You will most likely be... Thank you.
make everyone happy.
Far history, where we explore Earth's huge past. Today, we ask the question, where did life originate? Well, there are a bunch of theories surrounding this, so let's get right into it. Our first theory is abiogenesis, life from no life. It proposes that organic beings originated from non-living matter in hydrothermal vents. This creates a chemical soup that may have caused a reaction, creating the simplest forms of life. In the last episode, I told you that the Earth was literally hell. So how could life survive in such conditions? Well, Earth only stayed hell until oceans appeared around 200 million years since the Earth's formation. Water is the most important ingredient to life. Without it, life would have never flourished, and also helped cool the Earth down to a relatively comfortable 212 Fahrenheit. Transformium. Now this theory is a bit more far off, but it's the most interesting. It suggests that life came from another world and exists throughout the universe. When asteroids or other space dust hit a fertile planet, some of its debris gets ejected back into space, possibly containing life forms. Around 4.1 to 3.8 billion years ago, the Earth experienced a late heavy bombardment, possibly indicating that life may have arrived from those asteroids.
AG, BFG 6, FG, 9G, BFG 6, 9, BFG, FG, AG, 8, BFG 5, 4, 8, 9G, 2.
Fellow Americans, for the past few months, our citizens have been under attack by a new and deadly force, a fungus that affects the minds of our citizens and causes them to kill other people. Our scientists and police forces have been making efforts to contain and treat the infected, but it's only had a minimal effect. I have also declared an emergency in San Diego City, so I now advise every citizen to stay inside. If we don't act now, this may escalate into a countrywide epidemic. We may possibly deal with hundreds of thousands of deaths. I wouldn't want that on my citizens. I hope we are able to get through this. Thank you.
Thank you. In a hotel in Key Loop to hike roughly 25 miles south from here. I'll be hiking through the El Turista Radius trail around 3 p.m. Hopefully, I'll be back before nightfall because temperatures can plunge down to 32 over there, especially in January. Wish me luck. I made it stop. I didn't see my way on the top since I didn't want to waste my tape on long and mundane walks. It's quite a good view up here.
Hello? Hello? You need help? Hello? What's going on there?
Anyone in here?
There are many theories about their extinction. One is that the dinosaurs' destiny was written in the sky. A cosmic shower of asteroids or a large meteor struck the Earth with an astounding impact.
Good afternoon, Ms. Campbell. I'm here just asking you questions. I know this whole situation right now is a lot for you to handle. Being locked away in a room, far from your loved ones, and subject to rigorous tests that have probably pushed you past the point of exhaustion. But the reason for this is that you might be able to help us end this whole epidemic. It has been 3 weeks since you were diagnosed with the fungus. How are you feeling right now?
I'm fine. Facial pain's been gone for 2 days. Then the cough's gotten worse.
You've completely lost your urge to smile, right?
Yeah.
Huh. That's interesting. You're the first person to have this variant of the disease that we are aware of. Every case prior to yours has ended in a violent death. You seem to have recovered from it. You see, our early understanding of your case is that it's a late bloomer. Its course runs slower, but eventually it will kill the host. I think we should investigate if your recovery is the result of a weaker, non-lethal variant, or if it's because of your immune system. If, and only if, it is entirely your immune system responsible for your phenomenal recovery, we can extract your antibodies, free from vaccinations, and for immunity, and possibly make a cure.
Well, I hope that's the case.
Now, let's talk about the incident. Is there any reason why you were not following standard safety protocols in the morgue? Miss Campbell?
I wasn't in my right mind at the time.
Can you elaborate?
I was in grief. I still am. I couldn't cope with that at the time. I couldn't focus. I could have not shown up for work today. But I had a son to raise. And without its father, it's so much harder to do. Now I'm here. Stuck in a laboratory.
I'm really sorry for your loss and your stay here. We can send your son here to talk to you. I know it's been agonizing spending your time in here away from him.
Please do.
Alrighty then, I will be in touch soon. You need your rest. You will be further researched in the coming days. Just hold on tight. We might see an ending to this ordeal.
The research laboratory was infiltrated by the Smiler. Despite the high security of the facility, it was not able to withstand the enormous wave of Smilers. Everyone, the personnel and subjects were killed in the bloody raid.
Thank you. I was there during that whole outbreak. I stayed in my basement for a whole year.
Yeah.
I had to get used to living in such a claustrophobic space where I'd risk getting, you know, infected or brutally murdered by those psychos. The tricky part was getting food. You know, I'd carefully walk around streets with a gas mask, avoiding the infested areas, and the competition for food was like really, really high. So lots of fights would happen, in supermarkets that were abandoned, with like a high chance of like a Smiler, you know, intervening. And I got to witness one myself. God, oh my God, it was the bloodiest thing I have ever seen. It was insane. And later on, the outbreak, we learned that these like seemingly unstoppable variant disease could be burned by heat and caustic. And it was quite the revelation, because it was quite the revelation that we needed, because we realized that we could fight back with these, you know, impossible to kill Smilers. And I mean, those creatures could lift cars and survive bullets. And they were really scary because they also don't really even look like humans anymore. So when it finally ended, you know, I decided to move to San Francisco for good, because initially I was too traumatized to stay in that city. Went through a violent outbreak. And since then, you know, I've led a peaceful life, got married, had a child, but, you know, that whole outbreak, it feels like it just ended yesterday. It's hard to believe it was 20 years ago. Time flies.